Okay, so hello everyone. I guess we should start now. My name is Piotr Żarowski. I'm from Poland. And this talk, the main purpose of this talk is to convince you that there's a tool that can make it a lot easier to initialize packaging work of Python libraries. So you don't have to do everything from scratch. This thing will speed up a lot when you want to create a new package, a completely new one. So, PyPI, or Python Package Index, is a repository of software written in Python, mainly libraries, but also applications. And PyPI to DEP was created during DEPConf in Heidelberg, and it was meant to be a wrapper around SDDEP. SDDEP is a tool that converts Python packages into Debian packages, and it does it really well. If you don't know it, even though it's not developed anymore, I still encourage you to test it, mainly to use the PyPI install script, which will install a package, a Python package as a Debian package. So it does what PyPI2Dev does, but PyPI2Dev, I wrote PyPI2Dev because I wanted to focus more about converting the whole repository. In the end, I provided also the PyPI2DSP script, which does many things that SDDEP does, but I did it in a... I couldn't extend SDDEP that much, and so I decided to write something new. And PyPI to Debian is something that will convert the whole repository. So PyPI to DSP, DSP stands for Debian Source Package, will create a single one, and PyPI to Debian will try to convert a whole repository or a subset of PyPI repository. And the main features of this project is it uses PyPI metadata, so all the homepage, author, description, and classifiers. Not only to get a list of projects, but also while converting them into Debian packages. The ones that are not data that is not available in the Darwin. And it supports all the main interpreters we use in Debian, so CPython 2, 3, and PyPI. When it detects Sphinx documentation, it will create a new binary package with regenerated documentation. It integrates well with Debian tools, with DHPython, with I reuse a lot of stuff from Python Debian library. For example, if given package is already in Debian, it will reuse the name. It guesses build dependencies in the generates build depends field using names from Debian. Or if given library is not available in Debian, it will guess the name which applies to our policy. It generates, for example, it also generates ATP email, so something that Debian developers would be interested in. it doesn't send it, so you can review the email and polish it a bit before sending. It's easy to customize. I will talk a bit more about it later. And for Debian Python modules team, something that team members may be interested, it integrates really well. It, for example, initialize the Git DPM repository. It sets all the VCS browser source fields, maintainer, and so on. And it even suggests commands how to create a repository on the IOF, how to push which branches and so on. There are two lines that handles everything. So Debian Python module team members may be interested in this tool. And so how to use it. The first script that converts a single library or application, but it's mainly written in the mind of converting libraries. You can just invoke the script name and library name. It will download the tarball or the zip file. If it's a zip archive, it will recompress it, repack it, so that into a format accepted in Debian, into a tarball. It will fetch all the metadata from PyPI and Debianize it and create a Debian source package. If you want, it can build a binary package as well, but you have to add another command. If you already have a tarball, you can point it to Py2 DSP and it will handle the tarball without fetching the data from PyPI. If you already started packaging and you have sources unpacked, even if there are partial Debian directory present, Py2 DSP can create everything that's missing. And the last example is for Debian Python module team members. The profile option is one of the possible customizations. It will set quite some options in order to produce source package that is in align to our team policy requirements. It will also, for example, create all this Git DPM initialization and configuration. And the second script, PyPI to Debian, will try to convert PyPI or any other repository compatible with PyPI into Debian repository. It will convert only fetch a list of projects and convert all of them into Debian source packages. If you want to compile them, build them as well, you can point PyPI to Debian to the tool you use to build package, for example, sbuild. You can, if you point sbuild to an unstable distribution, it will build all the packages for unstable. If you have a stable chroot or Ubuntu or any other Debian derivative, it will build packages for this derivative. If you want to, for example, if you don't want to convert the whole PyPI repository, you can use filters like classifiers here. You can use multiple classifiers, so this example will use only packages that are compatible with Linux, but you can specify more if you want to use those who work with editors. You can just pick the right classifiers and fit PyPI to Debian with it. And the Python 3 option here will create only Python 3 binary packages, because by default both tools will create binary packages for each interpreter that upstream author claims given library works with. So it, if it has a classifier that says this package works with Python 2 or PyPy, it will create binary packages for all these interpreters. But if you want to limit it only to Python 3, you can do that with option as seen on the example. So there are multiple ways to customize it. There's a profiles like in the example for Debian Python module teams. And there's another. It's really easy to create new ones. I created one for DPMT, one for Python applications packaging team, and one for OpenStack team, but it's probably old already because I created it like 2 years ago, and the policy probably changed. Another mechanism is overrides. By default, both tools will search in current directory in the subdirectory named as the same as source package name, and you can use that or set PyPI to the overrides path environment variable, which will where you keep all the overrides. But the overrides, it's meant for overriding settings or options for one package only. If you want to change something for all of them, you can customize templates. Templates of Debian control file, Debian rules files, or ITP email. If you want to have a different one, then you can just pick the templates I created and modify them and put them in different directory, and they are the Jinja template is used to render them. So Jinja is quite powerful template engine, so you can use if statements and so on to modify it and to customize it. And another way to customize it are hooks. There are currently two hooks, pre and post. Pre is invoked before Debian directory is created, so the sources are already unpacked, fetched and unpacked. And the second hook, post, is invoked once the Debianization is already there. So both are just simple scripts. So if in overrides or in templates in directory there's a hooks pre or hooks post file which is executable, then it will be invoked. And I use it, for example, to set up a Git DPM repository. If you have a completely different, want to use completely different source repository, like a private company repository for with compatible with PyPI that you use to keep libraries used in your company, then you can point PyPI to dev using these two variables, PyPI JSON URL and PyPI XML RPC URL, and PyPI to dev will use it instead of official PyPI. So in both overrides, profiles or templates directories, you can put just static files like git build package configuration or Debian copyright file if it's static, if you don't need it to be changed, if it's the same for all libraries. You can use TPL files, so templates in Jinja. So if you, for example, know that this tool doesn't detect correctly upstream author, or you want to hard code the upstream author to some string, you can either use the CTX context JSON file and put all the values from these fields like author, build depends. If not all are detected, you can change description, home page, and so on. There are quite a lot of them. So you can do that either in context JSON file or in if you are upstream author and you want to help Py2 DSP or Py2 Debian, you can use setup configs Py2 DSP section. It will read all the options from there, or you can hard code them in TPL files. And pre and post hooks are simple shell scripts which get as options when invoked package name, they get package name and version. And if you need more, the CT context JSON files are created as well in the build directory, so you can read them from scripts and use all the detected values from there. And if you don't like Jinja, want to use your own template engine or for whatever reason, you can just use the detection mechanism and invoke everything else from the script. And that's the first part. I will make, if we probably don't have time, but I will try at least show you a few examples. But in the meantime, if you have any questions, then please ask. If not, I will try to... Is that big enough? Fetches metadata from PyPI, chooses the latest version, downloads it, and repacks it, and Debianizes it. It already did that. So as you can see, there's a maybe I will show it. There's a ITP email template. I don't see that here. If the usually upstream authors add change logs into package description, so Python DSP is clever enough to recognize that and remove it, and a few more hacks I added to polish it a bit, but it probably needs more work. But anyway, the ITP email looks complete. You can there's a description, there are binary package names and all the fields from ITP email. There were examples detected, so it's the right. I will just show control files, and so as you can see, detected Python 2 and Python 3 interpreter, and there's a separate doc binary package. Upstream author probably didn't mention PyPI, that's why he didn't create one, but let's try to build it. And in the meantime, are there any questions? Because I have to finish. Yeah, it worked. So there's an address, there's the Python binary package has the same name. You can apt install PyPI to dev and try it yourself. Thanks.